For the crumb, mix together all of your ingredients as well as your small cubes of butter and mix until you get a wet sand texture. Set this bowl aside. For the cake, mix together your softened butter and granulated sugar in a stand mixer with a paddle attachment or a hand mixer until it's white and fluffy. In a separate bowl, mix together your flour, cinnamon, salt, and baking powder and give it a whisk. Next, you're going to add your vanilla and your 4 eggs one by one into the sugar and butter mixture until it's combined. Don't forget to stop and scrape if you're using a stand mixer. Now we're going to alternate adding into our batter about 1/3 of the flour mixture and 1/3 of the milk in 3 stages. After each stage, make sure you stop the mixer and scrape the bottom of your bowl to ensure that you have no unincorporated flour or lumps in your batter. If you are using a stand mixer, keep it at a low speed, and if you're using a hand mixer, keep it at the lowest setting. We really want to keep from over mixing your batter, so if you notice, I'm gradually adding the milk not too long after I add in the flour. Then I'll stop the mixer and using my spatula, I'll scrape the bottom of the bowl. Again, I recommend you keep your mixer at a low speed, or if you're using a hand mixer, keep it at its lowest setting. I promise you, not only will it keep you from having your face dusted with flour, it's also going to ensure that you don't add unnecessary gluten. We're aiming for a moist, yes, I said moist, and tender coffee cake. You really want your batter to look fluffy and smooth by your last addition. After this, in a separate bowl, go ahead and mash your bananas using a potato masher or a fork and add that to your batter. Fold that in with your spatula and set aside while you spray your pans. We love this banana bread. It's definitely an awesome recipe if you have old bananas laying around. Our bananas were about 4 weeks old and were pretty much black. Preheat your oven to 350. If you don't have baker's joy, you can use shortening to coat the inside of your pan. Dust it with some flour and then dump out the excess. So now we're going to go ahead and start putting our batter into our pans. You're gonna wanna do 4 layers. So the first layer is gonna be batter. The second layer is gonna be your crumb mixture. You're gonna do another layer of your batter. And then the last layer is gonna be your crumb mixture. If you want, at this time, you can also mix in whatever types of nuts you want. So if you wanna do walnuts or pecans, you can go ahead and add that into your crumb mixture. Good rule of thumb, if you are using aluminum pans, make sure you use a cookie sheet underneath them and put them on the top rack because heat does go through them faster than nonstick or glass pans. Because everyone's ovens are different, I would recommend setting your timer for 10-minute intervals so that you can rotate your pans if the sides are browning too fast. So at about 35 minutes, our 6x3 aluminum loaf pans came out. At 43 minutes, our 8x8 nonstick pan came out, and at 50 minutes, our 5 1/4 by 9 inch glass loaf pan came out. The best way to check to see if your loaf is done is just to insert a knife or a toothpick and make sure it comes out clean. And that's it! Pour yourself some coffee and enjoy your coffee cake. Let us know if you guys make it. Also, comment on our Instagram or Facebook and let us know if you want us to make anything else. Thanks, guys!